I want to believe sincerely that fortunately we are talking about the Honorable Justice Adetunji Adefarasi here. I'm proud to say that he's an old boy of Igbobi. So we are talking about a man of integrity. We are talking about a man of integrity who was not afraid to invite lawyers to his house because he knew clearly that the fact that you have visited him does not mean that if you appear before him, you are going to get judgment if your case does not merit you getting a judgment. And I think that at this stage, I want to really plead with our judges. There is no reason why, if one is sure, as I believe many of them are, if one is sure that he or she is incorruptible, there's no reason why one cannot lend a hand, particularly to young lawyers, as I've given myself as an example, who need the hand now. I think many of our judges now, particularly because of the stories that go around, have become very timorous. So you can't even make a call. You can't even do anything. The question, as soon as they see a lawyer's call, the call is shut off. I do not understand why that should be so. And I do not think there's a reason why one should pretend that one knows, that you know a lawyer. My Lord Justice Obadino, I have known from the time she was in secondary school. I appeared before her. There is no reason why I cannot appear, because the fact that I'm appearing does not mean that my knowledge of her would make me to have any advantage before her. So, but now, what I see is that as a result of the fact that there's a need for you to be too careful, even old friendships are now severed. And by the time one retires and you want to go back to that friendship again, one cannot go back to it because the person will say, oh, you are coming to me now. Why did you deny me when you were on the bench? So I think that the independence of the judiciary has to do with confidence. It has to do with self-assurance. The self-assurance and the self-confidence actually comes from the integrity that is within. If one is sure that one is incorruptible, one should be able to defend himself or herself anywhere. And that does not mean that one should pretend his relationship or a relationship with anyone. If one sees that there's a lawyer who wants to take advantage of it, that will be a ground to cut that lawyer off. If one sees that even there's another colleague, because it's not just lawyers alone, even colleagues at the bench can take advantage of it. You can find a judge approaching another judge saying that, why don't you offer me help in respect of it? One can cut off such relationships. And I believe sincerely that, which, as I would say, I would admonish that my Lord should begin to do that. The last point I want to make here, it may be funny, is that please take your invitation to the election tribunals very, very sparingly. They should begin to see, now politicians should begin to see that judges are reluctant to come to election tribunals. They should begin to beg them to come, rather than find a judiciary that is so eager to go and serve in a place where people will accuse them of collecting bribes. They should know that your lordships are more ready to work where you have been called, which is your primary constituency of listening to disputes that come to you. Let them begin to file the election petitions at the registry, at the High Court registry, rather than constitute some specific tribunals where they will now go and mess up people who have integrity because they want to ruin their names.